Tonight on CTV News, international tennis returns to Christchurch. The government claims affordable housing is coming to Wigram, but is it affordable? And blowcarting sails in. Broadcasting across Canterbury from the CTV studio, this is First at Five. Good evening, thanks so much for joining us. The government's calling it the biggest and most affordable housing scheme in Canterbury yet. But what exactly is affordable? More housing is planned for Wigram, but as reporter Marcus Skibbs found out, the devil is always in the detail.
This is the latest government solution to help meet the post-earthquake housing demand in Christchurch. Wigram's Awatere Cars Road housing development is a joint venture between the government and Fletcher's Building. The homes will be built on 11.5 hectares of Crown-owned land. Work will kick-start by the end of this year, and the first home will be ready for sale next year. The entire development will be complete by 2017.
But we also want to try and drive the development of more affordable housing product for very average Canterbury families who are either trying to rebuild their lives after the earthquakes or those younger families that are aspiring to home ownership.
However, only 50 of the proposed 237 new homes are aimed exclusively at first home buyers. These have a price tag of $350,000 and a government shared equity scheme attached. Another 39 homes will still cost less than $400,000, but will be sold on the open market for anyone to buy, even investors.
Of course we'd all like houses at $300,000. You actually need to find somebody that can build them. My view is that these are new homes, they're good quality homes, they've got good amenity, and in my view they are less than the average house price in Christchurch, and for that reason is going to help the affordability challenge that we have in the city.
The bulk of the homes will be priced at $400,000 and above, out of reach for most young buyers.
So no, it's not easy, but in my view the combination of a site such as this that produces product at $400,000 plus the Home Start scheme, plus the Welcome Home Loan, is we are going to open the door for hundreds of families in Christchurch to first home ownership.
The cheapest of the homes will be provided through the Housing New Zealand Foundation as part of a shared equity scheme.
The Housing Foundation retains an equity in that home. It may be at some time in future the family is able to buy out that equity from the Housing Foundation, or the Housing Foundation retains that equity in the home until it's sold.
Fletcher's has been involved with the government building homes since 1904, when the company built the first weatherboard houses in Dunedin. These new modern homes will range between 2 to 4 bedrooms in size.
Two level, single level, semi-detached, some fully detached. It's a very big range of product that we're providing.
The plan originally proposed to build 275 affordable homes, costing between $350,000 and $500,000. This has since been scaled down. The missing 38 homes have been swapped for public spaces like a playground and wetlands.
I think that reflects the real push from the Fletcher Group to not just build homes but actually build quality developments. When I look at the amount of recreation and open space, I think this is going to be a wonderful community in the future.
The Housing Minister also hinted this won't be the last housing development. The Minister is working on two separate proposals in Colombo and Wells Streets. He'll take the proposal to Cabinet next month and hopes to make another announcement before Christmas. Marcus Gibbs, CTV News.
Well, there's more good news for Christchurch's sporting community. The Davis Cup has returned to the city, bringing the first international tennis event since the quakes. Gordon Finlater talked to New Zealand players.
New Zealand and Chinese Taipei named their teams for tomorrow's Davis Cup tie at Wilding Park this morning. New Zealand captain Alistair Hunt named Michael Venus as his number one, with Ruben Statham playing as the number two singles player. Ruben, the most experienced player in the Kiwi team, will be first up, playing the Chinese Taipei number one at 11 a.m. tomorrow.
Oh, it's good to be first up, and you know, if you wait around from 11 a.m, potentially the first match could be 5 hours, and it's a lot of waiting around. So it's nice to play first up and get the start, the tie started.
Ruben spent a large spell of the last 12 months out with injury, but is happy with his return to the game with recent success in North America.
Yeah, surprisingly well after such a long way over. I made back-to-back finals, the first two pro events back, and yeah, my form has been pretty good from the get-go.
Team captain Alistair Hunt is happy with the team's preparation. With many of our top players having career-best seasons, Al already had a good idea of how he would line up his team for the weekend.
Well, you always have in your mind what you sort of want to do. The main thing was probably this fella, how he's, you know, he's obviously had a tough year with injuries, so how he was going to pull up, but he's pulled up well and he's getting better day by day, so yeah, he'll go well tomorrow.
Marcus Daniel and Artem Sitak have been named as the doubles pairing for Saturday. The pair are more than familiar with each other, having won a Challenger tournament together in Canada back in July.
It is very important. The more you play with someone, the better you play together. And Artem and I have been lucky enough to play, I think, 7 or 8 events in the last few months, which is a lot. And we're very comfortable on court with each other, so hopefully that can translate into the tie over the weekend. Rankings are moving in the right direction. We've beaten some really, really top teams recently, and we're both feeling like we're playing well, so there's no reason we can't win. We're just going to go out and do it on the day.
The doubles tie is sure to be pleasing on the eye with the fast-paced, short-point version of the game, always a crowd favourite.
There's more emphasis on the volleys and the serve, whereas in singles you can get away with having a slightly smaller serve and sort of scurry around to the baseline. In doubles it's more tactical and bigger shots and faster reactions.
The tie serves as a relegation match for the Asia-Oceania Group 1 section. If New Zealand are to guarantee high-end opponents in the future, a win is vital this weekend. With tickets still available, a strong showing from Christchurch locals looks set to decide if Christchurch can yet again become the country's home for Davis Cup tennis. Gordon Finlater, CTV Sport.
Tonight, we continue our series looking at the future of Christchurch schools following the government's decision to either axe or merge them. Reporter Marcus Gibbs takes a look at Kendall and Richmond schools.
Richmond School was another casualty of the earthquake. The minister chose to close it because the buildings were tired and old, and the school had shrunken to 19% capacity. All 7 buildings suffered earthquake damage. Repairs and strengthening would cost $900,000. However, students are still coming back to Richmond School, and as early as next year. Tepa or Rakai Hoto School is a new character school. Already 96 students are enrolled.
Their idea is to provide something that's missing in the educational sector.
The school will have a strong focus on Te Reo Māori, and before they move in, this rundown school needs a fresh lick of paint. All up, $1.5 million has been proposed to be spent on renovating and repairing the buildings.
A lot of that funding will be things like furniture and equipment that can be reused again. It'll be for some of the specialist facilities like ICT, stuff around technology, you know, the hard technologies and things.
It was announced yesterday that the school will only be at Richmond until Linwood Intermediate becomes available. The school then plans on moving there. The Education Ministry now says that the repairs are likely to be scaled back. As with the other schools, the long-term future of the site isn't known. On the other side of the city, Kendall School seems empty without the laughter of children. It was also closed at the end of last year. However, the buildings are still mostly in good nick, and the plan is that for the next 5 to 10 years, local community and government groups will be able to take advantage of the empty classrooms.
For at least the next 5 to 10 years, this will be used for a number of community groups as well as schools.
Thousands of school children will be affected by the Education Ministry's rebuild and repair program. Kendall School will eventually be used as a temporary school site for displaced students.
It's quite a lot easier if the kids can come somewhere else. We've got about 75,000 students across the greater Christchurch that are going to be affected by the rebuild and the modernisation of their assets. So if they can come to a place like this, it's great.
The ministry has already trialled the concept of a decanting site at Linwood Intermediate, finding it to be successful.
They can have a temporary school here while their own school gets upgraded. You know, it minimises disruption and such to the school while that goes on.
Children haven't completely left the school. A kindergarten is based on site while its building over the fence is repaired, and they'll soon be joined by another group.
And we've got the Blind Learning Education Network of New Zealand soon to move in with Van Ash for the locals.
Schools are bound by legislative requirements when it comes to the disposal of assets. But questions have to be asked. Will the school eventually be subdivided for housing, or will it remain empty once the students and community groups have moved out?
certainly a lovely spot. The reality is we all, we're bound by some legislative requirements and a process that has to follow about disposal of any assets. I mean, we'd also look to say to the council, to other agencies, hey, do you want to use this for some other purpose? So, that's certainly a long way down the track.
The Education Ministry has promised that the closed schools will continue to be used and won't end up as empty and ugly landmarks. Marcus Gibbs, CTV News.
Coming up on CTV News, we preview the Indian Festival of Lights and what on earth is blow karting.
PhoneQuip, the place to shop for a great range of 2 degrees mobile phones, accessories and USB modems. We can also set you up on a pay monthly plan or you can purchase your prepaid top up. To view our range of 2 degree products, visit our website or simply head in store.
Yuck, look at all this moss and lichen. I'm not getting up there, not in these heels. Time to call Mossbuster.
Mossbuster is a no-bleach, non-abrasive, biodegradable solution that has over 35 years of proven results. You can buy Mossbuster online for less than half the cost of other well-known products and can be yours for less than $1 a litre. You just spray it on and let Mother Nature do the rest, or Mossbuster can do it for you. Check out our website or call the Mossbuster crew for a free quote. Mossbuster, 0800 88 1000.
My son's helped me greatly with my independence now that I've got more mobility.
Mum, I've been looking into stand assist chairs from More Mobility. They recline back with a footrest, then when you want to get out of them, they stand you up. You can even sleep on them. More Mobility can bring one out for a free trial. There's even electric beds too. What do you think? For more range and more expert advice, see More Mobility, corner Clarence and Princess Streets off Blenheim Road.
What a difference More Mobility makes.
Action Removals, offering short or long-term storage facilities, full packing services, comprehensive rates, all fully insured and with 6 vehicle sizes to choose from. Earthquake repairs? Action Removals pack, move, store and return your valuable possessions stress-free. Action Removals, a family business that has been operating in Christchurch for over 10 years. Action Removals, your one-stop removal service, on time, every time. 0800 222 526.
Welcome back to CTV News. The New Zealand Blow Kart Championships begins in Christchurch today. Now, I know what you're thinking. What on earth is blow karting? Joel Batista went out for a ride.
Exploring the blow kart. This Sports New Zealand Open kicked off in Christchurch this morning. The Canterbury Blow Kart Club is hosting the four-day event, with many of its own members competing in the races. Canterbury's president, Terry Helm, says the art of the sport is to go faster and get closer to the wind.
It's a buzz. It's just the speed, the freedom of it, and it's the challenge of trying to beat someone on who's level with you, same sort of weight and sails, and just the competition of it.
Invented by New Zealander Paul Beckett, the blow kart is one of a kind.
It's probably a cross between go-kart racing, speedway and low flying. It's a really great, exhilarating sport.
Paul Beckett grew up sailing and hang gliding. When the sport turned dangerous, he created the blow kart.
Land sailors at the time didn't pack up quite so small, but I designed this to pack up into a check-in luggage and a suitcase, and you can check it in on the plane and sail it anywhere in the world.
15 years later, and the blow kart has gone global. Paul Beckett says when he began drafting designs, he never expected the land yacht to become so popular.
There's about 12,000 blow karts out there globally now. New Zealand's not the largest, most popular country for it. It's really big in Europe, and they've got blow kart associations all over the world now.
Here in Canterbury, the Blow Kart Club has 65 members. They come out to Wigram Air Force Museum to race every Sunday afternoon. When asked if blow kart racing has improved his driving, Terry says the two are very different.
Definitely not. Doesn't make me more aggressive, but you don't have to have had sailing experience to sail these things. Most people can actually get it moving within 5 to 10 minutes.
In New Zealand, Paul Beckett says the sport is growing organically. What he really wants to see is the younger generation getting involved.
People from 8 years old up to 80 years old can sail it, can sail it competitively. So it's just for all those speed freaks and all the older guys that never got to, I guess they're trying to relive their misspent youth in a way, you know, out there doing skids.
The National Blow Kart Championships runs every day until Sunday at the Air Force Museum. Joelle Batista, CTV News.
I think Joelle was having far too much fun. Back in the office, please. One of Christchurch's most popular festivals is back this weekend. Once again, Joelle Batista gets the hard end. She previews the Diwali Festival of Lights.
A celebration of culture. A chance for these young girls to get excited about their Indian heritage.
It comes from India, or north of India, from Punjab. So what the junior gathers are, it's a very traditional ladies' dance that happens at weddings and celebrations.
The Diwali Festival of Lights will be celebrated in Christchurch this weekend. The event will have arts and craft, indoor pyrotechnics and traditional dress-ups. Organisers are expecting more than 18,000 guests.
And it is a big event for in Hindu. It's an ancient culture where we believe in wealth. It's our New Year as well on Diwali. And it's for good health and prosperity in your life. So that's why we do it on a very grand scale.
Diwali event organiser Sharon Gulati says there are thousands of Indians living in Canterbury. From food to live performances, Diwali is a chance for Indians to share their culture.
We're just trying to showcase our Indian culture that people are not aware of in the past, and to show that living in New Zealand, we still want to showcase with our young children, and they're going to do it through the music of dance.
Samia and Seema performed a traditional dance today, just a sneak peek of what's in store for Saturday.
Very nervous, but also happy at the same time.
Because now we know how excited and nervous it feels like being on that big stage.
What these girls love about the traditional dress is the bright colours.
I like that it's nice, all colourful and cheery and makes you, you know, it's like openly and just make you all nice and colourful and yeah, same.
Sharon says the Indian culture is vibrant and colourful.
It's very colourful. We love about the food. It's all about the food on the day. And it's a very colourful culture. We can show quite a lot of diversity around us that what we have got to offer. And it's a fun thing to do.
The Diwali Festival is at Horncastle Arena this Saturday. The doors open at 3 p.m. and the performances start at 6. Joelle Batista, CTV News.
Still to come on your local news, the business report and your local weather.
Yuck, look at all this moss and lichen. I'm not getting up there, not in these heels. Time to call Mossbuster.
Mossbuster is a no-bleach, non-abrasive, biodegradable solution that has over 35 years of proven results. You can buy Mossbuster online for less than half the cost of other well-known products and can be yours for less than a dollar a litre. You just spray it on and let Mother Nature do the rest, or Mossbuster can do it for you. Check out our website or call the Mossbuster crew for a free quote. Mossbuster, 0800 88 1000.
Action Removals, offering short or long-term storage facilities, full packing services, comprehensive rates, all fully insured and with 6 vehicle sizes to choose from. Earthquake repairs? Action Removals pack, move, store and return your valuable possessions stress-free. Action Removals, a family business that has been operating in Christchurch for over 10 years. Action Removals, your one-stop removal service, on time, every time. 0800 222 526.
My son's helped me greatly with my independence now that I've got more mobility.
Mum, I've been looking into stand assist chairs from More Mobility. They recline back with a footrest, then when you want to get out of them, they stand you up. You can even sleep on them. More Mobility can bring one out for a free trial. There's even electric beds too. What do you think? For more range and more expert advice, see More Mobility, corner Clarence and Princess Streets off Blenheim Road.
What a difference More Mobility makes.
PhoneQuip, the place to shop for a great range of 2Degrees mobile phones, accessories and USB modems. We can also set you up on a pay monthly plan, or you can purchase your prepaid top-up. To view our range of 2Degree products, visit our website or simply head in store.
Warren Head is in the studio now with this week's business news.
Hi, I'm Warren Head from headliner.co.nz. Today's big business headline is that inflation is well and truly under control, running at a very, very low rate because of very low food prices through winter, which kept the costs down. We're kind of heading for that area now where the 1% to 3% range that the Reserve Bank looks at for interest rates is where the inflation rate is, sitting right in the middle, in fact, trending down towards the bottom end. So the banks are saying today, look, there's no need to put up interest rates again until possibly late 2015. So it looks like we've got a whole year to work out the mortgage payments and get something sorted there. So that was all good stuff. And on the food front, talking about low food prices, restaurant brands came out with their quarterly results today, and quite a big increase there, 6% in the sales by KFC. They seem to be very popular. Margins have improved. Sounds like chicken's a little bit less expensive than before, so that's where that would be coming from. And the numbers quite outstanding over the whole company for the month, almost 5% up on sales. KFC, Pizza Hut and Starbucks all doing very well with very strong results. And also in the food sector, just to remark on the trend going through with PGG Wrightson, one of our big companies here in town, annual meeting this week, and they commented about how well New Zealand agriculture was going and picking up also in Australia. Things are not quite as grim as it might seem because of the dairy price going down. And they did comment on that too. They estimated that, okay, it's still a very good payout price if it gets around $7, and if it gets down around the forecast, 24% lower at $5.30. They will feel that at PGG Wrightson stores throughout. But they're hopeful that as things move forward, it won't actually get to be quite as bad, so we'll have to wait and see. On the dairy farming front, there was a farm fund launched this week to finance people who want to reinvest back in their farms or encourage the kids to buy the farm, a big issue these days because of the value of these big farms. And this is called the New Zealand Dairy Farming Trust, raising money for big lick investors, I would say, not public investors, about $750,000 up if you want to get into this trust. But it would lend money out based on the milk price. Now, the milk price of $5.30 means that the loans would be, guess what, 2.6%. Now, if the milk price was back at last year's level, $8.40, the interest rate would be 8.8. I think I've got the intention of every farmer out there who's got a kid they want to bring through into farm ownership. In the context of the markets, there's a new launch coming up. The Orion Healthcare Company will be looking to float in the new year. In fact, its prospectus and IM will be out shortly. It should be cleaned up by Christmas and on the market in the new year. And it's raising about $120 million to $150 million worth of shares. No price yet, but that'll be coming up next week. And on the question of what do you get on the phone at home, the FMA is saying if you get any of those incoming calls that ask you to transmit funds overseas quickly or act now or miss out, just hang up. This is a scam going around, and it's linked in with some shady websites as well, so just be aware if you get any strange calls, that's who it might be. And if they put out a big brand name in front of you, that's also a myth. Take no notice of that. And finally, just to close, if you're going away for the long weekend, good news today, petrol prices went down. They're down about another 2 cents a litre. They've been falling since the world price for oil dropped, and that is coming down now quite steadily. With a slowdown in the Northern Hemisphere. So the price of a litre of 91 octane this weekend will cost you $2.139 a litre, $2.139. I dare say you pay a little bit more the further you move away from the big city. I'm Warren Head for headliner.co.nz.
Thank you, Warren. Nice to meet you. Well, now it's time for the region's weather.
Good evening, here's your region's weather. First in Timaru, Temuka and Geraldine, 21. That is boring how people talk. Moving north to Methven, Ashburton and Rakaia, they hit a high of 21 degrees. Making smart with the words again. Darfield, Leeston and Ralston hit one of the region's highs on 22. Looking now at Lincoln and Christchurch, a sunny day for you hitting 22 degrees.
Never not chasing a million.
Heading over to Akadoa, slightly cooler on 21. In the Waimakariri district, Rangiora, Kaipui and Amberley hit the region's high of 23. Moving north to the Huronui district, Culverton, Hanna Springs and Cheviot, 21 degrees. And at the very top in Kaikoura, 22. But what's in store for tomorrow? In Timaru, showers clearing during the day, but skies remaining cloudy till evening. Expect cold southwesterlies dying out, hitting an overnight low of 7 and a high of 11 degrees. Ashburton, showers in the morning, but dry in the afternoon with gusty cold south winds easing out. 7 degrees overnight and 11 throughout your day. Christchurch, cloudy and cold with showers till mid-afternoon. Expect gusty southwesterly winds as well. 7 degrees at night and 11 during the day. Kaikoura, damp and chilly all day. Expect gusty southwesterlies. 7 degrees overnight, reaching a high of 11 during the day. And in other areas around the region, Temuka and Geraldine, 10 degrees. Methven and Rakaia, expect showers all day, hitting an overnight low of 7. Darfield, Leeston, Rolleston and Lincoln, showers for most parts of the day with a high of 11. Over in Akadoa, expect a high of 11 and low of 7. Rangiora, Kaipui and Amberley, showers for most parts of the day, hitting a high of 11. Culverton, Hand Springs and Cheviot, a low of 7 and a high of 10 degrees. With the fun again when I'm known. And looking ahead for the rest of the week, fine and sunny on Saturday with moderate cool northeasterlies. Milder, moderate northwesterlies for most of Sunday, with high cloud increasing during the morning. Expect a cold, blustery southwest change during the evening, with some rain and snow developing to 400 metres at night. Showers clearing but skies remaining cloudy till evening on Monday, with moderate southwesterlies and very cold temperatures. Frosts are likely on Monday night. And mostly fine and sunny on Tuesday, with moderate cool northeasterlies. Expect high cloud to increase later on in the day. Another very cold southwesterly change is expected on Wednesday, with strong winds and showers and snow above 600 metres. And that's all for your region's weather. Have a lovely evening.
So Saturday's still looking like the best day for Labour weekend. Well, that's CTV News this Thursday. Thank you so much for joining us. Have a great night.
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.